Ya, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, class.
Good morning, Teacher Zaman.
Okay, before we start, we're going to recite doa sebelum belajar. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Rabbi syrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Okay, let's just recap back our previous lesson, which is about the effect of human activities towards environment. As you can see here, one of the reasons are deforestation. Yang ini deforestation is a process where the removal of trees and other plants from environment for the purpose of building, for agriculture, for roads, for houses, and for buildings. So that's one of the what do you call the changes that is being caused by human activities. Another one will be the pollution. So I've already explained to you there are three types of pollution: air pollution, land pollution, and water pollution. So basically, air pollution is arah kontak udara, land pollution is arah darat, and water pollution is arah air. So we already talked about this last time. Now we just gonna go through here. Okay, pollution, land pollution is being referred to rubbish that's been thrown from our house, from our home, from the school, from the shop, everywhere. So this is another type of pollution which is being dumped in landfills. Example of land pollution. Water pollution is also happening in our precious Kampung Air. As you can see, if you go there, you can see a lot of rubbish near the river side. For example, like this, you're going to see bottles, plastics, containers, and so on. So this is another example of water pollution. And another one is air pollution. This is occurring when there's a lot of traffic. The exhaust fumes from cars release carbon monoxide, which is released to the air, and this causes air pollution. And also bush fires, smoke from fires also causes air pollution. Now, for all those the problems that occurs, what we need to do is we need to conserve the environment. So conserve means for me cuma mengurangkan, tadi cuma menyelamatkan. So how do we do that? Human activities can harm the environment in many ways. It is important that we learn to conserve, menjaga the environment. Conserving the environment means protecting it from harm and keeping it healthy so that organisms are not harmed. It also means that we need to use our natural resources wisely and not waste them. So, kita perlu menjaga, menjaga daripada terus dimusnahkan alam sekitarnya. So, how do we do that? So, firstly, we need to reduce pollution. Tapi perlu mengurangkan pencemaran. Okay, you have learned that human activities can cause land, water, and air pollution. So what can we do to reduce pollution? Apa yang tadi perlu buat? So we have seen this big short video here. Yeah? Great, huh?
The amount of pollution we produce. We can reduce land pollution by not littering and placing our rubbish in bins. We can reduce water pollution by not littering and treating wastewater that is released into our waterways. reduce air pollution by walking, riding a bicycle, or using public transport instead of a car? What are some other ways we can reduce pollution?
Okay, from the video you can see that one of the ways that we can reduce pollution is we don't use anything that produces pollution. So misalnya, if you travel by car, you can also travel by bicycle. Bicycle doesn't use any kind of energy. It doesn't use any fuel. So that way you can reduce pollution. So reducing land pollution, an easy way to reduce land pollution is to keep our environment clean. Always dispose of rubbish properly by placing in a rubbish bin and do not litter. Sampah perlu dibuang dalam tong sampah. You cannot just throw it anywhere you want. You can also participate in cleaning campaigns. At these events, people in community get together to clean up rubbish at certain places. For example, the beaches in Brunei Darussalam. Sari janganlah masa ni posa pada dorang di pantai. Okay, next one. How do we reduce water pollution? Wastewater from homes, factories, and other buildings is called sewage. Ini tempat kamu tahu, kalau kamu tahu yang sewage ini yang bawah tanah. Air bawah tanah. Sewage contains solid waste, harmful microorganisms, and other poisonous substances. To reduce water pollution, sewage water is cleaned at a treatment plant before it flows back into rivers, lakes and the sea. This helps to keep our rivers and oceans cleaner. So air yang kamu gunakan itu, sebelum ianya dilepaskan semula ke laut, ia ada tempat penapisan air, tempat loji air. Air itu ditapis dulu. Pasalnya banyak sudah, ia banyak sudah tercemar oleh manusia, misalnya air minyak kayak apa sajalah. So this one is a sewage treatment plant. Ia membersihkan dulu sebelum dilepaskan ke sungai ataupun ke laut. So that way we don't really pollute the water. Next, reduce air pollution. You can help to reduce air pollution by walking or riding a bicycle instead of using a car if you live near a school. And also you can share car rides with your friends or neighbors. Kalau ke sekolah kamu boleh apa? Carpool. Carpool ni boleh menumpang orang lah. Kalau sekiranya kamu sama jiran kamu, tak payah tak apa muantar, ikut kawan saja. So in that way you are reducing air pollution. So this is just the topic that we covered for today. And this one is for the next lesson on Thursday. So okay. Before I forgot about, I should show you this one. So today our lesson is just at least two ways on how to conserve the environment. And how to do that is to define what conserve means, I already explained to you. And how we conserve the environment, I already explained to you. And show examples of how to conserve the environment, and I also explained to you. So what are the two ways on how to conserve the environment, Damia? Bolehkanlah buku.
Oh, juga ada sudah.
Bah.
Dispose. Jadi.
Nah.
Juga ada sampah dalam tong sampah.
No, okay. Another way is just to reduce pollution. We need to reduce pollution. That's just one way. Salah satunya apa?
Dispose of rubbish properly.
You walk rather than use the car. You walk, and then water before it was being flown back. Before it being flowed back to the ocean, it needs to be treated. Okay. So today's lesson is very short. Tidak berapa banyak. Kau juga pun tahu kamu puasa kali, kamu puasa kamu kah?
Puasa.
Puasa.
Tidak okay. Dah, puasa lah juga.
Okay, you just tunggu lah. This book, I already explained about. Endangered kan?
Sudah.
Nih, mana tiak? Wait. This one, endangered extinction. Sudah saya explain kena?
Sudah.
So today your lesson will be, your work will be on page. Tunggu, I want to share to you. Hari ini kamu buat muka surat. Okay, kamu buat hari ini muka surat 78 dan 79. 78 and 79.
Oh.
Okay?
Okay.
Okay, before we end, any questions? Yes.
Ay, Selina, hindi din cakap.
Okay. Any question?
Yang ini gunting ka.
Ha?
Are we exactly gonna cut this? Are we gonna cut this?
Cut what?
Oh.
Oops. Let me see. Wait.
How are we going to?
Wait. Give me 1 minute. Let me check. Okay, page 78. It says there, number one, list 5 kind of plants, animals in Brunei that are endangered. So you need to do research, huh? And then number two, states to reason why these animals are endangered. Kenapa? And then number three, create an awareness poster about endangered animal in Brunei. So what you do is, you find a picture of an animal that is endangered in Brunei Darussalam. Contohnya, proboscis monkey. What else? You do your research lah. You search in Google. Kamu cari binatang-binatang yang hampir pupus.
Hampir pupus.
Terus satu, kamu print gambarnya dalam itu. Kamu tampal tu arah hitam atau the black box. And after that, you explain. Describe. Karakteristiknya apa? Di mana tinggal? And then, yeah, why is it endangered and how we can protect them? Okay?
Yep, juga.
Use Google or also your textbook. Okay, any question?
No.
So, I think that's no. It for today. Ini baca doa, selepas belajar.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Belajar tuh. Selepas belajar. Bahas lepas belajar. Wes.
Apa juga?
Bapak cerdas lepas belajar.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Allahumma inni as'aluka hudawatuka wal afafa wal dina. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Amin amin ya rabbal alamin.
Ada soalan ah?
Nada.
Okay, see you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye.
Bye.